Hello everyone, this is MJ with MinIO and welcome back to the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. In the previous video, we went over deploying a MinIO tenant using the command line, and we talked through some of the slides and some of the nuances about deploying a tenant. And in this video, we're actually going to walk through the lab and actually do a deployment of a MinIO tenant using the CLI, as well as access that tenant using an ingress and make sure that we can actually use that tenant to do standard MinIO functions. So let's jump into it. Before I actually show the lab environment, however, I do want to reference the docs. Make sure that you visit the MinIO documentation page for the most up-to-date information about how to perform these tasks, as these steps may change over time, and you want to make sure that you are doing it the best practice way that is listed in the documentation. But here we are on the docs page, and we'll include a link in the description below. And you can see here that this is how we go through and deploy a MinIO tenant using kubectl MinIO tenant create. There are some required fields, as indicated before, so make sure that you are filling those in. And there are also a number of optional settings that you can choose, as you're going to see in our lab here. But again, this should be your reference point for where to start and build out your commands that you're going to deploy your tenant with. All right, now let's actually go over to the lab environment. All right, so here we are in the lab environment, and the first thing that we're going to need to do is to define these tenants in their own namespaces. So a namespace has to exist to keep tenant separation within Kubernetes, and so we need to define a separate namespace for each of the tenants that we're deploying. So let's go ahead and do that first. We're just going to run a kubectl command to create a tenant namespace, rather, called MinIO tenant 1, and that was pretty quick to create. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and stand up the tenant. So let's walk through what this command looks like. We're going to say kubectl MinIO tenant create. We're going to call the tenant MinIO tenant 1, which matches our namespace. It doesn't have to match, but just for human understanding when you're looking at these things, it's better if your tenant deployment matches the namespace that it's in so it doesn't get confusing. We're going to define a capacity of 20 gigs. Obviously, this is a test environment, so this is very small, but you would define it based on how much space you actually want to provide to that tenant. There are ways to increase that in the future by defining separate pools, but that's a different video. Also, because we're in a test environment, we're only going to define one server because we're running on a single node, but likely you'd want to run 3 just to make sure that there's redundancy across the cluster in case one of these servers fails. You don't want the tenant service to stop working. We're also defining a single volume within that. So again, in order for erasure code to work properly, you would want to define multiple volumes to be created so that the erasure code could function as it should. And you can use the erasure code calculator to also do physical servers. But if you go on the website and look at the erasure code calculator, you can actually figure out the number of servers and the number of volumes per server to get the proper erasure code spread that you need there. The namespace is the namespace we just created, so we're going to deploy this in MinIO tenant 1. The storage class that we're using here is DirectPV MinIO, so we're running DirectPV on this system. Again, if you are running in a different system, make sure that you are choosing the storage class that you need and that actually exists on your system. We're going to enable what's called host sharing, which means that basically it's going to be able to access this using the ingress that we define. And we're also going to disable TLS for this because we don't have TLS configured in our system right now. Again, we're going to have an entire series on configuring TLS, not only for native Linux deployments and Docker, but also for Kubernetes. So make sure you check out the MinIO YouTube channel for that. So we're going to go ahead and run that. And you can see that that creates rather quickly. And it gives this output here of the username and password. Very important. Save this information. This is only going to be displayed once, and you're going to need this to access your MinIO tenant. So I'm going to go ahead and grab this information and copy this off so that I can reference this later. All right, so now that that's done, if we do a clear and a kubectl get pods minus a, we can see that there is a deployment for the MinIO operator and all of the things that the MinIO operator needs to actually do the sort of underlying structure for deploying a tenant. But we can also see that because we defined a single server in that command for MinIO tenant, that there is a MinIO tenant 1 server up and running here. So that should be good to go. We should now have access to that. Now that the tenant is deployed, we should actually be able to see that tenant in the MinIO Operator console. So let's go ahead and log in using our JWT. And once we get into the console, we can actually see that the MinIO tenant 1 has been created with the 20 gigs of capacity that we defined via the command line. And it's showing green is healthy. And if we come down into metrics, we can actually see that there is one server here, one drive as defined by the command line, and that we don't have any buckets or objects in here yet, but that this is actually being recognized by the operator and it's available to start using. Next, we are going to deploy an ingress for that. So I've already defined an ingress. Let's go take a look at that ingress. If I look at my files here, I can see that I have a MinIO tenant 1 ingress. So let's take a look at what's in that file. So here I am saying create an ingress. The ingress name is tenant 1 ingress. The namespace is going to be created in the namespace that we created for that tenant. So it's MinIO tenant 1. The ingress class name, we're using ingress nginx. So our ingress class name is nginx. We need to define that so it knows which ingress controller to use. The host name that we're going to access this on is MinIO tenant 1 DSO demo.org. And this is actually going to point to the backend service for MinIO tenant 1 console. And so those are the things that we need to define within our Kubernetes ingress to make that work. Now we can do kubectl apply minus F tenant 1 ingress, and that ingress should be created. We do kubectl get ingress minus A. We can see that now we have an ingress for the operator, which is how I just showed you that the tenant was created, but also a ingress for the tenant as well. So let's go ahead and look at our browser and see if we can get into the tenant now using the credentials that you definitely saved when I told you to earlier, right? So we will come in here and go to that link and proceed to that. And now we are being presented with a credential page to log in using those credentials from earlier. So let's go ahead and do that. And here we are. Now we are in a tenant that is deployed on top of the MinIO operator running in our Kubernetes cluster. And this is what we would expect to see here. All right, so what you saw there was us deploying a MinIO tenant using the MinIO crew command line and kubectl command line tool. Hopefully that gets you started on deploying this. Obviously, when working in Kubernetes, there are a lot of other complexities, like things that you need to know regarding ingress and TLS and things like that. So hopefully you can use some of your additional Kubernetes experience to figure out those other things. As I said, we will have other courses that talk specifically about MinIO TLS and other things that would be related to this deployment, but that is not for this particular video series. Thanks so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video.